How's it going, guys? Today we're going to jump right back into this Narnia mock-up that I've been working on. I've added a few other instruments. I worked on the strings as well as the percussion, and I've been adding some winds and just kind of solidifying some of the parts. It's still not perfect yet, but I want to show you guys basically what I've been doing since the last video that I was just doing the brass on. So here is where the mock-up is so far. Actually, let me play you the original cue and then I'll play the mock-up. Here we go. Okay, so that's the original cue. Again, it's called To Aslan's Camp from the Chronicles of Narnia, Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, music by Harry Gregson-Williams. So, I'll show you guys quick what I have done so far as where my mock-up is at. Then we'll go a little bit through some of the other instrumentation and some of the added elements that have come up. So yeah, here is the mocked-up version so far. So I've added a bunch of new instruments and I'll kind of walk you guys through what I've added. So last time all we had was basically the brass here, right? So I had the French horns, trumpets. I still haven't done the trombones yet. I feel like there's some low beefy lines that I think are probably just solidifying the bass part, but that's really key. So I'll probably do those in a bit. So I've added the timpani and the cymbals, and what I'm using for this is basically just Hans Zimmer. Hans Zimmer percussion. So it's got a nice timpani sound. So you can hear that. And it basically just kind of solidifies the bass. So we have also, if we play the cellos and the bass with that, so you can see what it sounds like. So you have that there, as well. We have these short lines with the violin ones, violin twos. I also layered the viola. What I've done with all of these is I've actually layered them with this hybrid synth, which is really key. It just adds a little bit of beef, so you can hear it here. Let me actually just play it with all the synths soloed. So basically I've layered every single string line with these synths. Just to give it some beef, and a little bit later, like with especially with the basses, what I'm gonna do is actually layer it with like a sub bass. But for now, this synth works, so you can hear what this sounds like. Kind of sounds ridiculous without the strings, but here are the main lines. Right. So, and then you layer it with the actual strings. So there, basically the high string lines for that part are just kind of like these accented, first these triplet things, and then these, they're all basically like accented, kind of like a staccato feel. Again, here's just the violin ones, twos, and violas isolated with the synth layer. So it goes from moving like the moving basically with the chord. So just a D minor. Then to a B flat, and then it does a little line where it's like, right? As far as the main melody line, the violin ones. And then I layered the twos, doing a harmony as well the violas. Basically, the cellos and basses are kind of doing just long lines, legato kind of patch. And what I'd probably do with this bass, which I'm probably going to do in the next video, is just solidify that with this nice sub bass. So sometimes I like to use Contact has some decent, I mean, you can get sub basses anywhere, but specifically in Complete, if you have a Complete Retro Machine sub bass one, love it. So key, just a nice low beefy bass. Probably can't hear it on the computer speakers, but anyways, I'll solidify that with the bass part after. Then we go into this B section where basically it goes from those fast notes, the ostinato kind of vibe, and then we go into this legato patch with the violins, the flutes come in, and then we have just some nice lines in the cello and bass. These aren't perfect yet at all, but I'll show you guys what happens. So we have some nice motion between the cellos and the violins there. Listen to this. Yeah, just a sec. I also layered the violas just to give the cello line a little beef. I don't have the release perfected on this stuff yet, so I'm gonna have to mess around with this parameter on not only the violins but the cellos, violas, everything like that. The basses are just doing a really nice, I think it's a, here, let me play this. Way faster than it actually is, but that's the idea. The timp actually does that too. That's what I gotta play in next. So let's do that. And then I just want these videos to be real quick. And we're already at like 8 minutes here. So let me play the timp in and then I'll do another part on the rest of this. This is really getting there, so I'm really pumped up about this. Again, just so fun to take these apart and try to get the samples to play it. So let me play the timp line, if I can remember. We'll see how it goes. Oops, there we go. Screwed that up a little bit. What the heck is this? Definitely shouldn't be there. Anyways, I'm gonna have to go through this in a sec here, and then just kind of work on that, get the notes right. But yeah, that's the idea. So far so good. Again, here's the mock-up so far.